but couldn't give a toss. You know, this is the only paper I know that when you wipe your ass with it, more shit comes off it. All right, Papa, you're moving.
Don't rush me.
Look, Papa, why don't you just give up?
No, I've got something here. Let me see. It's a seven-letter word. It's a 50-point word.
Wait, Papa, Papa, Papa. There's no such word as gazinta.
Sure there is.
Look, Papa, if I agreed with you, we'd both be wrong. There is no such word as gazinta.
There is. It's an arithmetic word.
An arithmetic word? Gazinta?
Sure. Two gazinta four.
And a five gazinta your lip. Poor Papa. His mind is not what it used to be. Papa, what is a two times a two?
It's 169.
No. Papa, what is a two times a two?
It's a Wednesday.
No. Papa, watch my lips. What is a two times a two?
It's a four.
That's right, Papa. How did you work it out?
I subtracted 169 from Wednesday.
Papa, I'm not Gina, I'm Rosa, remember, your daughter-in-law? Gina, Mama, sings with the angels now.
Oh, she does? Oh, yeah. Oh, I hate getting old. You know, it's a losing thing. First it's your eyesight, then it's your hearing. And I can live with that. This is trying to take something from me that I just won't give. I can't lose my chin, not again.
Oh.
Hey, Rosa.
Yeah?
Whiskey. A 10-year-old Scotch. 10-year-old.
10-year-old Scotch?
Aye.
Well, that's you rent us out of the court.
They'll not be the same since Trapattoni left.
Lippy's calling the shots.
So I see.
I'm back in Milan.
Into?
Hey, see?
Ancelotti's lads, they've got four.
Are they out?
There you are, one eye.
Oh, no, that's 5-year-old. I want 10-year-old. 10-year-old Scotch.
10-year-old?
Aye.
And you've got the Germans.
They're Munich.
Borussia Dortmund.
They do know how to play that beautiful game.
Bastards.
Here you are, one eye.
No, that's 7-year-old. I was 10-year-old. 10-year-old.
10-year-old?
Aye.
Not forgetting your Dutch.
The Dutch. The silent killers.
Ajax. Feyenoord.
Oh. Vanoy Donk. Lassie.
There you go, one eye.
Real thing at last.
Now, try this.
Single malt.
Try it.
Oh, that tastes like fish.
Yeah, now tell me all that. Hour is upon us. It is said that a true friend should always underestimate your virtues and an enemy overestimate your faults. Enough play! Boys, boys, boys. Time for work!
Hello, boys. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. You two have got yourselves into a right old pickle, haven't you? Where's your tusk gone? Here it is. To be honest, you look better clean shaven. It takes years off you. Now, this is what's going to happen. You can either make this easy, or we can make this very hard. So what's it going to be?
Is this some kind of a joke?
Do you see anyone laughing?
You're mad, mad! Look, you let me go, and I'll let you off with a warning.
You're not going anywhere, Sunshine. You've been knotted by the best. What is that, Mama?
That's a double cow hitch and a fisherman's knot.
Nice. Now, this is how it's going to be, lads. During our absence, our dear sweet Mama has tried to steer the ship as best she could. Hasn't always been plain sailing, but she did the best she could.
Her very best.
Then one day, two great big icebergs came into view. And for the first time, the relief captain of the SS Botty found herself in choppy waters. So now one of you,
or both,
of you, are going to have to pay.
SS Botty? Choppy waters? Icebergs? What's you on about, man?
Ah, ignorance is a bliss.
Isn't it just?
Oh, just you wait till I get out of here. You won't know what's coming for you.
If you get out of here.
Oh, you can do away with me, but there'll be another 100 just like me.
Well, we believe in quality, not quantity.
Look, I'm an FSA officer. An FSA officer? You know what that means? It means with one swipe of my biro, I can bring your kingdom tumbling down. You're as good as dead.
Well, being as dead doesn't really bother me, Mr. T. Because I've been as good as dead many, many times. And so has my family.
Look, I'm just doing my job. I don't care about your bloody family.
Well, you should, Mr. T. You should.
What? A pair of jailbirds? Waldorf and Stackler there? And a Lamproom?
Oh, like that.
Well, I got Lamproom, cheeky bastard.
Very quick to threaten frail old little ladies, aren't we, Mr. T?
Hey, enough of the all! You're not helping, Mama.
Arthritis, angina, cataracts, osteoporosis, type 2 diabetes, hypertension, and
but apart from all that, I'm cock-a-friggin' who? Fino!
The frail little old lady? She's a bloody barnport. She won't listen to reason. She refuses to adapt. Well, she's a pain in the...
Pain? You want to talk about pain? Oh, well then. Look over there. Now he used to be a torturer. One of the best.
Oh, and you decided to follow in his fingerprints, did you?
Oh, I like that. And he had a knack of knowing when fellas were lying to him.
Well, I'm shitting myself.
I don't know if he's telling the truth.
Old habits die hard, eh, Grandad? Now, see him.
See me.
See you, old Jock.
Hey, it's me, Jock. It's Alistair, you bastard.
Sorry, Alistair. Now, he used to be a torturer. And you only crossed him once. And if you were clever, you'd never cross him in the first place.
Look, there's some of the history lessons. Let's just forget the party game, shall we?
This isn't no game, Mr. T. Far from it. And then
there's my dear brother, Curly. Or as we knew him in our fraternity, Butch. You know why they called him Butch?
Because he face looks like bulldog's ass.
That's one reason my Greek Cypriot friend.
Bollocks!
No. It's short for butcher. And not because he does a nice ribeye or lamb shank. No, no, no. It's because he can carve a man up in 15 minutes flat.
Oh, I wouldn't break my record with these two fat bastards!
Ah, your pot's killing me!
Why don't you shut your lardy trap, you great streak of paralysed pigs?
Now I'm looking at my brother's body language. And he doesn't look best pleased. So a word of advice.
Don't ruffle his feathers.
I've seen your picture in the paper, Mr. T.
Oh, really? Well, we all have our 15 minutes of fame, don't we?
Week after week, that slimy grin of yours turns up somewhere between the obituaries and the Sunday League fixtures. Last time you showed up on page 3. And you ain't no Sam Fox.
No, you do have the tics for it.
No! Week after week we're there, closing down some greasy spoon with relish.
And it's not Branston Pickle.
Very good, Curly. Very good. I'm not saying you're wrong. There are some real dives out there. But the thing is, Mr. T, we are one of them.
Never have been.
Never will be. True. We may not have always had money to burn. Though my brother has been known in the haze of Carlsberg special brew to wipe his arse on a white fibre.
Better than Isle.
But Mammon has never let a standard slide.
Not once.
Yeah. I may not have always been one of God's academic children, but why have you put the squeeze on the body and not on that licensed salmonella trap next door?
Hey! Shooting you cat!
It just doesn't add up, Mr. T. So, my friend, enlighten me. Oh dear, Gar's got his tongue. Bad pussy. Okay, your turn.
I know telling you shit.
Good. That's just the way I like it.
What, crazy?
Crazy! This one's getting right on my tits. Now, you listen to the nice man. Capiche?
You see, Sicily was always invaded over the centuries, and the Sicilians learned the only way to survive the invasions was to only trust in their family and never break that trust. Now, we're all upset because you've been making our mother's life a living hell. And as you've probably gathered, she means the world to us. She is our world.
Shall I recite my poem, Carl?
Curly, you must have read me mine.
Poetry?
My brother pursued a degree whilst we were otherwise engaged.
Open University, English Lit.
He's always been a wordsmith.
It frees my mind.
Oh, a writer and a fighter.
Shoot in your sucking hell, dog shite!
You are like a rose. When God picked you, you were the best mother he could have chose. You kept us warm when it was cold. With your arms around us, you did fall. Our bellies never empty, our tears always dry. When I think of you, it is with pride. Mama, you are like a rose.
Beautiful, darling. Just beautiful. Can't you right there, doesn't it, Mr. T?
Oh, yes.
What was that song she used to sing us to sleep with?
Little old lady passing by,
catching everyone's eye. You have such a charming manner, sweet and shy.
Little bit of business here, little bit of business there.
Sticking in the boot when they please.
No more. When kneeling down, you look through the pantry door.
My mother used to sing that song to me, too. But I don't remember that last bit.
So, Mr. T, you're going to tell us one way
or another. Santa Lucia, Santa Lucia. Hey, boys.
Yes, Mama.
Did you hear about the Chinese godfather? They made them an offer they couldn't understand. Ah, sweet laugh, the music into my ears. Curlier, I've been meaning to ask you, son, what happened to your curls?
Porridge, Mama, porridge.
You know, I had the same problem when I had my woman's trouble. They told me to apply yogurt. I really shouldn't have used a Muller fruit corner. That's right. So claggy. You know, my potatoes smelled like apricots for a week.
That's plenty. I thought you were going for wine.
Oh, you wine, all right. All night long. Drink
it. I never touch it.
Never?
No, never. My grandfather was the same. He never touched a drop in his life. And he lived till he was 75.
Get away. My grandfather lived till he was 105. Drank every day of his life. He's been dead 20 years. We dug him up last week and he looks better than you do now.
This is Rosa. This is Botty. Rosa Botty. If I've offended you, forgive me. I apologize. I'm only human. You know, there's an old Chinese saying, for every 20 wrongs a man makes, ignore 19.
You know, there's an old Sicilian saying, for every wrong a man does,
he gets a fat friggin' lick.
Tell me, Mr. Trauman, you ever seen one of these? Yeah. It's a bloody antique. Yeah. Used to take an age. Yeah. You have no idea how tough human bone can be. This was how we used to do it. The older fashioned way. But I know you're a fan of a change, Mr. Trauman. So this is the new way. Sorry, boys, sorry, but you have to stay awake. Otherwise, this is all a complete waste of time.
You're nuts! Nuts! In 19 years of devoted service, I've never come across a family quite like you. You've torn me coat, you've scuffed me hat, and you've bent me nail back.
Well, I hate you, friends. I've always hated him. I hate everything about him. And I hate the people who wear him even more. Without your uniform, you're nothing. You're nobody. And that's exactly what you are. You porky bag of castrated donkey nuts!
You have a wonderful way with words.
Shut it, you slag!
Come in, Mr. Trauman. Rats gnawing on potatoes, congealed grease on the worker's surfaces. That doesn't sound like Barty's.
Oh no, that sounds more like a happy kebab.
I mean, you couldn't have gotten the reports mixed up, surely.
That would be an awful accident, wouldn't it?
Certainly would, Mama.
Well, I was only following orders.
You regular little Nazi.
Well, that's all there is to it.
He's a lie. I can smell it.
He always knows when someone's telling porkies.
It's a gift.
Look, you let me go and I'll get my boss to pay you a visit. You can deal with him.
Drop your mates, innit?
You bloody Judas.
Hungry, boys?
Ravenous.
Now, where are your manners? Guests are first. Oh, now look what we got here, Mr. Troutman. Fresh, fruity, nutty, Parmigiano Reggiano. That's a Parmesan cheese to you, Mr. Troutman. Oh, now, damn, I'm all out of the plates. I guess you'll just have to have it on this.
What do you think I am, a bloody contortionist?
I'm no Quincy. Let's see if that springs into action.
It's goodbye, Mr. Chips.
Would be a crying of shame if the old one-eyed beast was stirred from his slumber, no?
Oh, really?
Lights! Music!
Life is a moment of space. The dream is gone.
you. Do you know, I always thought you were tapped, but tonight proves you around the bloody bend. Yeah, I tried to reason with you, but you wouldn't get it into that head of yours. That stubborn Italian head of yours. Oh, you had to cling on to the past, didn't you? When there's a bright golden future at your fingertips.
You know about the offer?
No, wake up and smell in this cafe, Mrs. Botty.
What's he talking about, Mama?
You don't know.
Don't know what?
After all this, and we've been... You haven't told them, have you?
Told us what?
Nothing!
Oh, I wouldn't say it was nothing, Mrs. Botty.
Mama?
Yes. Tell them, Mama.
I knew it was a too good to last. Two, maybe 3 weeks before you came home, I received a phone call. At first, I thought it was a joke. They wanted to buy us out.
Who?
The developer.
Developer?
A.P. Merriweather. A ghoul.
Wasn't he the arson king?
Aye. He did a stretching all while we were banged up.
Oh, yeah, that's the one.
An offer was made, but I hung up. The next day, I received another phone call, this time from Mr. Big.
A.P. Merriweather?
No, John Big, Merriweather's associate. He put their case to me. He was calm, precise, charming even, but I refused to sell flat out. He hung up. I guess that's when the tide has started to turn against me.
We accepted.
Who's that? Oh, sorry, I forgot you were there.
It was good money. I'll have to go back home and sit on Arsene Son every day. We got no pennies unless you were on side.
Merriweather wants the full strip to fall like a deck of a cards.
What for?
Luxury apartments.
That old racket.
Where do you come into all of this?
He and developer's Porky.
You're not an inspector?
Of course I'm an inspector.
What about the bribe you tried to get out of me?
Well, pocket money?
Bent as a nine-bob nose.
Oh, aren't we all, eh? Are we all searching for that pot of gold at the end of the rainbow? Stavros?
He came to us first. He said if we wanted monies, we had to comply. We had to get rid of Spanner and Croc.
Eh?
We need them to work. Nana, she needs laser hair removal. Desperately. We had to play along.
And if we were closed down for health and safety, we'd have no option but to sell.
Nice.
Everybody in Nobody's best in town, spotless. It was all his idea. Planting of the dirt, the grease, the Mises droppings.
You dirty rat.
Nana hated it.
She has?
She respects you, Mrs. Botty. Always has done.
So all of this was for nothing?
No, Carlo, no, we've got to stand our ground.
No, Mrs. Botty, it's only bricks and mortar. Get in for a pretty penny, all of you. Why fight it?
How much are we talking?
Ask your mother.
Mama?
But Carlo, I...
Mama!
The rabbit replies, no. So the bear wipes his ass with the rabbit!
I'm not a rabbit! I'm a bear. A bigger bear with the teeth and the claws. I'm here to Syracuse. I'll chain myself to the door. No wrecking ball wipe Rosa Bottia. I'd rather be dead.
To find a new home.
Bigger and better than this place. The Botti Empire. It will rise like a phoenix from the flames. What really matters is in here.
When we lost our freedom all them years ago, they stripped us of many things. But they could never strip us of our love for you, for Carmen, for Grandad, even old Jock.
It's Alistair, you bastard!
Sorry, Alistair.
You start up again. In any old corner of this kingdom, north, east, south, or west, all that really matters is that we've got clout. And clout is our middle name.
Oh, it's nice, Luciano, and yours is just happy.
Don't split it, Mama. Split a bottle and raise a toast to all our futures.
Well, are you right? I'm an older fool. I've been telling you that from the start.
Well, Tom Frogman.
You know, there's an old Italian proverb that says, you can take the leaves off a tree, you can cut off its branches, but when the roots are big and strong, you can rest assured that both the branches and the leaves will grow back bigger and better than ever before.
Da Vinci, Rosa Bottia.
No hard feelings.
No hard feelings. Hey, you think I could borrow Chuck, please?
That's all.
Oh, no.
Davros, you have not been slept in. Have you been here all night? Why are you dressed like that? What's the smell? What's going on?
They know Nana.
You!
Stop! Nana, stop! We're getting too old for this shit. I know.
Uso?
Uso? For breakfast? Why not? Boys, all next door, let's make the most of this neighborly accord while we can, no?
Hey, Stavros, what about Stelios?
He's a puppet!
Oh, yes!
Where are we going?
It's a new day.
Who are you again?
Hello? Go ahead, I just need a minute.
Mrs. Botti, my heart bleeds. Purple piss! Morning, Rosa!
Oh, hello again. Oh, they're all up early this morning, aren't they? It's normally just you up at the crack.
What can I say, Fran? Spring is in the air.
Now listen, Rosa. Everything you need is in my box and ready for battery.
Listen, why don't you go next door? I'll tell you all about it.
So what about him?
He's already tied up.
Right, well, Mrs. Botti, I think this has gone on quite long enough now. You're violating my human rights. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Well?
Well what?
Well, release me, woman!
Oh, La Commedia è finita!
This is a new crazy world. Tradition is a thing of the past. No one knows what lies in store. So eat, drink, sing, dance, and make merry while you can. Salute!
Senor, excuse me.
Life is yours and fat man saying, sir?
It's horrifying!
Oh, yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, you have been a wonderful audience. Good night, God bless, take care of yourselves, have a wonderful summer. I'm a doctor! Yeah.